Hey everyone, it's Edie here, your video and YouTube strategist, and I'm coming in with an updated tutorial. Back in April of 2015, I did a video called Transferring a YouTube Channel from Google Plus Profile to your Google Plus page. And even though that process in essence still is the same, it looks a little bit different and there are a couple different names associated with it. So I just wanted to come in and sort of do a refresher tutorial, if you will. So stay tuned. So the question that you may be asking yourself right now is, why is it important for me to know this? Why do I need to know this? And essentially, if you have a YouTube channel that's connected to your personal Google account, you really should move it so that you will have a separation between your personal account and what I consider and call a business account. They're now calling those brand accounts. So you want to have that separation because it gives you a little bit more flexibility. Number one, the name of the channel can be a business name as opposed to your personal name. And also, you will be able to assign multiple managers to your channel. And the reason why you would want to be able to do this is so that anybody else other than yourself can manage the channel. And that means uploading videos, optimizing those videos, and writing the descriptions in, adding in the info cards, adding in the end screens, doing all of the management type duties that you would want to have done for your channel by someone else. And this way they won't need to have access to your personal email and login information for your main account because you're able to assign the responsibility to them through assigning them as a manager. So that is the reason why you need to look at this tutorial. So let's get started. So here we are on the channel. Now, assuming you've already created your secondary account, your business account, let's just assume that you have that set up already. So this is the channel that you're going to want to switch over to another account. So you're here on the home page. This layout may look a little bit different for you, and that's because this is the new YouTube layout. Until they've converted completely 100% to this, you're going to see that through this tutorial, it's going to switch back and forth to the classic version, which is what they're calling the older version. But this view right now is the new layout, and you can tell that when you click on the upper right-hand corner, your profile image, this window that opens looks completely different when it's the classic view. So things are a little bit different in terms of where they're located. Normally, right up here would be your Creator Studio and the icon for your settings. And now Creator Studio is here and settings is all the way down here. And that's where we need to click on. So once you get to your overview page, this is the account settings. This now has actually switched back to classic. And you can tell that when you go to the icon because you see Creator Studio and the tool settings icon up here. So the next thing that you want to do from this page is you want to go to advanced. And once you click on advanced, this new window that opens up allows you, if you scroll down under account information, it allows you to move your channel to your brand account. The old way, on the old video that I did, it actually said something about moving it to a Google Plus or profile or page or something like that. So that terminology has now changed. So we're going to click on Move Channel to Brand Account. And it's going to ask you to verify and confirm that you, in fact, are the owner of this channel. And so it's going to ask you to input your password again. So once you've done that, you're going to then come onto the page that states that you're ready to move your YouTube channel. So what you're going to see is how things are set up right now. So right now, your channel that has two subscribers, one video, and no playlists is connected or assigned to this account, which is your main account. So now you have to then tell it, well, what do I want it to do? And I want it to go to this particular channel after the move. So there's a button here that says select desired account. And when you click on that, there may be multiple accounts that you'll be able to switch this to. Or in this instance, there's only one because I only created one additional channel. And I just called it Edie's Test Channel because it sort of was a no-brainer way to do that. So once you're ready to move, you just click. Okay, so now on this page, you're going to see that it is going to confirm for you that you in fact want your existing channel that has 2 subscribers, 1 video, and no playlists to be connected now to Edie's test channel as opposed to my personal account, Edie Clarke. So if you are sure that this is what you want to do, you then will click on Move Channel. If you're not sure and you want to change things or you want to, you know, you're not really sure, you can cancel or you can click on Change Selection. So in this tutorial, we're going to click on Move Channel. It's then going to ask you again, are you sure that you want to move and update your channel? And if this is correct, this is what you want to do. It's giving you all of the information here. It's letting you know what's going on. Yes, you want to do it. You click on Move Channel. So now you can see that it has moved everything over to your test account. Now it's telling you it may take up to 10 minutes for updates to your account to be completed. And you're saying you're ready for this. So once you've acknowledged that, you just click on OK. And now you're done. Okay. It didn't take as long as 10 minutes, and I think it's because I didn't really have a lot on that channel. So once you have done this, you go back up to your profile again. This is looking at the classic view. And then you'll come down here to the channel that we just transferred everything to. Okay, so now we're just going to go under Creator Studio so that we can actually see what got transferred over. And once you come here, you can now see this is the name of the channel. You can see that 27 views transferred over as well as 2 subscribers. And here are all of the videos. And here are all of the videos that came over. And that's it. So that's it. It's as simple as that. It's a lot easier now if you need to transfer your content over. What you do tend to lose sometimes are the comments. I don't know if you lose them every single time, but more often than not, that's what you're more likely than not going to lose, are the comments. But you will be able to transfer your videos, you will be able to transfer any playlists that you have, and you will be able to transfer your views. Okay, so I hope this was helpful, and I'll see you guys later.